Hi, I'm Dr. Laura Gambrel, and I'm an assistant professor in the Marriage and Family Therapy Program at LaSalle University in Philadelphia, and I'm here to talk about two articles that are being published in the Journal of Marital and Family Therapy. They're entitled Mindfulness-Based Relationship Education for Couples Expecting Their First Child, and there's a part one, which focuses on the mixed methods results, and a part two, which focuses on the phenomenological qualitative results. So I wrote these two articles with my co-author, Fred Piercy, who is at Virginia Tech in Blacksburg, Virginia. And really, this research came from a combination of two of my major passions, which the first one is integrating mindfulness into interventions and programs with couples and families to increase relationship satisfaction. And then the second one is mixed methods methodology, which I really feel like can combine the best of both worlds in terms of quantitative and qualitative research. So my interest in terms of developing this study was really looking at how in the transition to parenthood, when couples have their first child, it's a very high-risk time. It's very challenging for couples. There can be a dramatic decrease in relationship satisfaction, and that decrease can be tied to a lot of negative outcomes for the individuals, the parents involved, and also for the children. So I developed what I called the Mindful Transition to Parenthood program. It's a four-week mindfulness-based program that really focuses on enhancing relationship satisfaction and preparing couples to enter into being parents together and helping their couple relationship remain strong through that process. For the study, we randomized 33 couples, so 66 people, into a waitlist controlled design or into the four-week mindful transition to parenthood program. And the program that they were in really involved mindfulness practices, psychoeducation about the transition to parenthood, couple relationship enhancement, and activities and exercises, and then homework that couples did to help increase their communication and to talk about co-parenting and how they can maintain intimacy through this transition that they were going through. And the results of this study were more significant for men than for women. I had almost all heterosexual couples in my study. So the men showed significant improvement and small to large effect sizes in areas of mindfulness, relationship satisfaction, various measures of empathy, and also positive and negative affect. And the women didn't show any significant differences between the treatment and control group, but did show some small effect size improvements in measures of empathy. So in terms of these results, we really wanted to investigate what was the difference between men and women's experiences in the group. Why did men have such a different outcome as a result of being in the group? And in traditional quantitative studies, you kind of just need to hypothesize or use theory to be able to determine these differences. But because we did a mixed method study, I conducted qualitative interviews with the couples at the end of being in the program. And that information really allowed us to be able to ask people what was meaningful, what was significant about the program, and then come to some conclusions about differences in experiences between men and women based on the reports of the participants themselves. In the second article, the qualitative themes that emerged really looked at differences that people experienced in terms of themselves, the couple relationship, feeling more prepared for their baby, and also male involvement in the program had some special differences and themes, which is consistent with the quantitative results. So in terms of the couple relationship, one of my favorite quotes comes from him, who talked about, "I feel that lately we've been there for each other and we're not trying to make someone who they're not." So she talked about how there was more acceptance in the couple relationship and less judgment. And one of the men in my program said, being a parent hasn't been a part of the language of who I am. But as a result of being in the program, he said, the baby is real to me now. Which I feel like is really a powerful outcome that men who were in the program started to identify more as fathers and connect more to their babies. So I hope you enjoy reading the articles and that you find something that you can use in your own clinical work. I think mindfulness is something that is becoming increasingly popular and that we can really use in our work with couples and in parenting to help enhance relationships, empathy, and really help families to be more resilient through life cycle transitions. Thank you.